Hello, everyone. Thank you for listening, and welcome to this latest Young Farmers podcast, which will introduce you to Coon Farm Machinery and the opportunities that they have for you. My name's Ben Eagle, and I'm really pleased to be joined today by a panel of the Coon team who are going to give you an idea of what it's like to work at Coon. On the panel, we have Sean Pritchard, the boss, managing director at Coon Farm Machinery UK, John Lovell, a technical support engineer in the south of England, and Kate Hughes, who is the marketing communications coordinator at Coon. Welcome to you all. Thanks so much for coming on doing this. Sean, I'm going to turn to you first of all. Could you introduce Coon to listeners first of all and explain a bit about the company's history and perhaps some examples as some of your machinery?
Yeah, thanks, Ben. Well, we've got a really rich and interesting history in the Coon Group. We started all the way back in 1828. Joseph Coon had his small forge in the Alsace area of France. He quickly developed the business and started producing agricultural machinery by 1864. And then by 1880, he'd already built his first foundry on the site, the same site that we have our headquarters today in France. By 1970s, we were starting to extend our range of grass equipment, and we built the first tedder, the first mower conditioner as well. And in 1975, we produced the first power harrow, which is a machine that we'd be very well known for in the UK. So once we'd sort of got to this stage in terms of developing our product range, we decided as a business to start to spread our wings globally. We have over 190 years of experience. We have 5,300 employees across the world, and we have annual sales of over 1 billion euros. Within that, a R&D budget of 4.5% of our sales, which is quite wow. High. Our main aim is to be a local company with a local presence. And for that reason, we have many factories on many continents. We have distribution subsidiaries around the world as well, like Coon UK. We also have importers. And with that network, we cover over 100 countries.
Yeah. I mean, you work very much on a local basis here in the UK. Tell us more about your work in the UK.
Yeah, we do work very much on a local basis, and we've been in the UK now for 50 years. The UK is a good example of one of the distribution subsidiaries that Coon has around the world. So we've been based in Telford since 1970. We're fully owned by Coon Group. And what we do is import machinery from our production sites around the world and market and distribute them to our network of dealers, and then in turn to our end customers and the farmers and contractors. In Telford, we hold a stock of machines, and it's also a parts logistics centre. And we have a team of 40 employees there who ensure the sales of machines across the UK.
Let's focus on the business today. How are you developing at the moment in terms of sales roles, tech support and marketing? You've already mentioned there's a significant R&D budget. What's the direction you're going in?
We doubled our sales force 5 years ago. We were aware that there were certain product lines within our range that maybe we weren't reaching the sales that we needed to. So we sat down, looked at what we were doing, and realised that we needed to put more emphasis on the actual sales in terms of numbers of people. So we went from six territory sales managers at the time to introduce six sales specialists who were covering specific product ranges such as livestock, sprayers, non-inversion tillage, and the drills, precision drills, and also parts. We also developed our technical support team over the last 10 years as well. We originally were, let's say, three technical support engineers, and we moved to a more area-based system. So we have six area technical support engineers and two members who are based in Telford currently. Then we go on to we have our marketing team, which is currently managed by Kate. And we've been developing this function over the last 5 years. And as with other departments, this department is constantly evolving to accommodate for new trends, and we'll shortly be looking for a new addition to complement the team, a person or a marketing assistant that has a bias towards data. That's very important going forwards.
Kate, let's bring you in here and talk about Coon and Young Farmers. How long has Coon been working with Young Farmers?
Thanks, Ben. Coon's been sort of working actively with Young Farmers for the past sort of 8 years or so through various different projects and events, things from AGM, getting involved in the Agri Forum. We've actually been supporting the Agri Steering Group for a number of years as well, that sort of links quite nicely with that. Things like competitions, such as our own Dream Machine competition, which involved trips to the factory as well in Severn, which is everyone always loves to go and see the factory. It's great to see the foundry. That's a real highlight. We've also got involved in sort of health and safety competitions, so providing machines to work with those. So there's various things that we've got involved in. And we, a lot of us are past sort of NFYFC yeah. members as well. So we all enjoy that aspect of it.
Sian, turning back to you, let's talk about career opportunities at Coon. For anybody who might be interested, what are the potential career paths open to people?
The paths are pretty varied, and they're very much tailored to the person and dependent on their profile. I mean, at Coon UK, there are opportunities within the sales function, marketing, which we touched on earlier. So, you know, there are digital data, product specialist type roles, technical support, sales support for both machines and parts. We also have a function of logistics. Also, not forgetting the important accountancy, administration, HR and IT yeah. functions. And all these are both sort of available management and operational level. So yeah. those are the sort of the types of roles that you can aspire to. Some people choose to evolve within the same function. So you may have a salesperson who becomes a sales manager. Others prefer to remove from one department to another to progress their career within Coon UK. In terms of the Coon Group, we would have all the same types of functions that you could move into from a career perspective. But we also have other things like the research and development, which I know a lot of people, young engineers, are very interested in today. And we have roles also linked to production and also the foundry. Yeah. It's vast. Yeah. It really is vast. Some choose to work in just one site. Some prefer to move from one country to another. And we have examples of a French gentleman who came to the UK to work as a work placement student. He then went back to work at one of the production sites in a production role. And today he works in Brazil. He's one of our directors of operation over there. And equally, we have students who go to the factory to work in the prototype department on a work placement. That particular person has come back to work in the UK as our product specialist.
Let's talk a bit about your own jobs and your own careers at Coon and how you got there. Kate, let's start with you. You first started with Coon through a placement when you were at Harper. Can you tell me about that and how it developed towards your current role in marketing?
Yeah, so basically after leaving college, where I studied business and events management, I then moved to Harper Adams, where I did a degree in agri-food and marketing with business studies as well. And during your third year, during that degree, you do a placement year. And I was lucky enough to get a placement at Coon, doing sort of a marketing and sales admin role. So that was sort of 2013, 2014. That seems like a long time ago now. But so after doing that for sort of 12 months, I also stayed on a little bit longer, sort of towards the end of the summer holidays. So got a little bit more experience again, gained there. And then once I graduated, I was then offered a full-time role with Coon Farm Machinery, sort of leaning to more the marketing side with the role I took there as marketing assistant. I guess from when I first started back there full-time to today, my role's changed and evolved quite a lot, as has the company, as Sian explained earlier. I really enjoy sort of being a part of the development of the marketing department again, as Sian mentioned over the past sort of 6 years nearly that I've been back with Coon, it's developed and expanded quite a bit. And so yeah, 6 years ago there wasn't a dedicated marketing team specifically in the UK. A lot of it was done through our head office in France and through Sian and the sales manager Duncan McLeish. So they sort of covered a lot of that before I sort of started to work a lot more on the marketing side and bring a lot more that we could in-house over here in the UK. There's now sort of Hannah, who's marketing assistant, are working with myself, and we have Katie and Ed, who are product specialists. Again, all of us have been YFC members in the past. So there's lots of different exciting things and variety of projects that I get to work on within my role. For example, I could be working and developing on launching a digital platform one day and supporting our dealer network on various topics. And then the next, I could be organising a large scale event such as LAMA that was over 2000 square metres stand space at the NEC. So I'm really lucky to have such a varied role within the company.
Yeah, just taking aware of that, I think it's incredibly exciting how Kuna's been growing and developing and just the variety of roles that are available. John, you're a technical support engineer. Can you tell listeners how you got to where you are today and what you do day to day?
Yeah, no worries. So day to day, I'm there to support our franchise dealers. So spread amongst the country are our Kuhn dealers. And if a customer had a problem with a machine, they're their first port of call for any technical support or advice. So, you know, ideally the dealer mechanic or technician will head out and get it solved and get the farm up and running. If it's a problem that's maybe has not quite seen before or wants some more information or it's just a bit unsure, then they would come to me. So I'd look after the south of England. So any dealer in that area would give me a ring or drop me an email, and then I'll try and help them over the phone or send them over some documentation or some list of key points to check, anything like that. And we try and get it resolved remotely. The next step would be to schedule in a visit, but we really do aim to get the farmer up and running with the dealer technician at the machine. Over the years, I've been here for 5.5-6 years now. It's getting a lot easier to actually diagnose and talk through issues over the phone. So, you know, less visits are required to get machines working. And we might just need to follow up visit just to speak to the customer about what happened and how we can get more out of the machine. Another key part of the job is to show customers how to use these technical bits of kit and to get the most out of them, to get what they've paid for, and to really make the most of their technology they've got available.
What would you say is the most sort of satisfying bit about the job?
If there is a technical issue and we can get it solved within a couple of minutes and get it up and running over the phone, that's a really good feeling, because downtime is the farmer's biggest like pet peeve and hatred. So yeah, to be able to get that done, that's where I get my buzz from for sure.
And likewise, on an overall scale, Sian, you must get a great amount of satisfaction from seeing people in your team across the business growing and developing in their roles.
It's great to see people grow and develop in their roles. I mean, especially lovely to see people come in from as graduates, for example, and to grow into you know, professional managers. It's wonderful. I mean, we had one colleague, although I didn't maybe see him through his whole career, but he retired last week after 45 years at Kuhn. And he would have been Kuhn UK's fourth employee.
He
started as a parts manager. He drove the lorry and met customers. He was the operations manager for many, many years, and then latterly he was responsible for the price lists and data sort of management, and so he had a full and varied career. It is possible.
I mean, what are those opportunities? What opportunities are there for ongoing personal and professional development at Kuhn?
I mean, it depends on the role that you're in, and the type of career path that you're choosing to go on. But I mean, there are opportunities for bespoke training. Equally, we do a lot of on-the-go training. There's also product training for both technical and sales. You know, we have things for people who are working in the parts department or the logistics department. They would be being trained on how to use the forklift trucks, for example, and things like that. But equally, there are opportunities for us to learn about other cultures when we work in transversal group projects. That can be quite interesting, quite rewarding. There are many different ways of developing within the company.
What advice would you give to any listeners considering a career in farm machinery generally, or perhaps specifically interested in working for Kuhn? Kate, can I turn to you first on that?
Yeah, of course, Ben. So I would definitely say to any sort of members of Young Farmers at the moment, take advantage of all the skills and opportunities that you can take from Young Farmers. There's so many different things such as organisation skills, public speaking, to gain confidence, that kind of thing, that, you know, you can really use and transfer into job roles in the future. I mean, for example, take pantomime organisation or cookery skills from competitions, club secretary roles or chairman, all of those are important roles that maybe at the time you don't think those skills are what you're taking from it, but believe me, you know, they do. Over time you realise, oh yeah, I learned that from Young Farmers, and it's quite nice to think back to those times. Something that I wish I'd done more of is public speaking. Okay. I was quite shy and maybe sometimes can still be a little bit, but that's something I've sort of had to try and develop afterwards. I wish I'd probably done more of it in Young Farmers and just had a go at it a lot more. I don't know if John wants to expand a bit more on this.
Yeah, and John, to perhaps take yourself back to your younger self, what advice would you have given yourself then?
I still am my younger self.
You're always your younger self.
Definitely, yeah, building on what Kate said, I think if you wanted to get into Kuhn or anything like that, it's important just to have a core set of skills, a set of, a trade, for example, that you can apply to agriculture. It doesn't have to be agricultural focused, but that core set of skills, like the public speaking. So in my role, being able to go to a farm and perhaps things haven't perhaps gone the best they could do. So, situation management, and also to be able to deliver training and technical training. So having that public speaking experience from Young Farmers and being nervous behind the podium there and juddering your bits of paper, and that you think back to that and think, I did it and I got through it, and I actually by the end of it I really enjoyed it. And the more you do, the better you get. So the younger you start, the easier it is.
Great advice. Sian, is there anything else that you'd like to add?
I think both John and Kate have given some really good advice, and I would like to reiterate that that it's really important to make the most of what YFC can offer you, but also don't be afraid to shout about these experiences at interview. Many of the skills that you can use are transferable into roles in the industry. Equally, I would say get yourself a good academic background. If you can, brush up on your literacy and your computer skills. Pick up a new language if that's something that you're interested in, you like doing. It could make the difference between you and another candidate. Also, be mobile. Don't be afraid to move area or country. Just get as much experience under your belt as possible whilst you're young. Just seize every opportunity.
Brilliant. And finally, Kate, where do listeners go to find out more?
To find out more, you can visit our website. We're also on various social media channels, such as Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, and YouTube. And also contact your local dealership. We've got a large network out there, and they'll all be willing to talk to you as well, not just Kuhn.
Brilliant. Well, that's all we have time for, but a huge thank you to Sian, John, and Kate for joining me. Keep a lookout for a couple of future YFC podcasts with the Kuhn team over the coming months, and go and check them out on their socials or through their website. On behalf of YFC and Kuhn, I want to thank you for listening to this podcast, and please do give it a share on your socials. Good luck if you're starting out on your career in ag, and hopefully we've inspired you today to look further. For now though, it's goodbye from me and the Kuhn team. This podcast was presented and produced by Ben Eagle for the National Federation of Young Farmers Clubs. It featured Sian Pritchard, John Lovell, and Kate Hughes, and was supported by Kuhn Farm Machinery.